The ABB FIA Formula E Championship is really such a groundbreaking endeavor and race series. So it's the world's first fully electric streetcar racing series. It's been around and completed 5 seasons. ABB became the title sponsor in January of 2018, and it's really been such an exciting opportunity for us to demonstrate our pioneering technology leadership and really partner with such interesting energy and enthusiasm to demonstrate sustainability around the world. ABB Formula E is really a testbed for technology development, and it's so exciting to see the world's top auto manufacturers are involved and have teams and are racing in this championship, as well as the official tire partner for the championship is Michelin. And to see them continuing to push the boundaries, like they're involved to develop their own technology that will be road applicable in the end, right? And that's really quickly that these innovations are going to make it into the vehicles we either drive or ride in all the time. So for instance, also the battery development has changed drastically. Even over the 5 seasons of ABB Formula E, right now that battery has double the range that it had just in season 4 to season 5. And so they're managing to make more efficient batteries that, you know, can charge and regen at a better rate to actually support racing. So that's really interesting. The tires themselves, the compounds have been continuously studied to make one all-weather performance tire. So you're not carrying around 10 sets of tires for each car as you travel around the world. You get one set all day long. So that's really learnings that can be applied to what we will use in the future. And that's really exciting to see. We've also seen that these electric race cars are now able to go the full length of the race, because of that battery range. So it's really great to see how quickly you can develop technology when you get a lot of energy and a lot of focus and create the platform for that to happen. In the mobility space right now, I think some of the most interesting things that I see and hear about around the world are the way that ride sharing will impact how we think about mobility, the ability to really develop major infrastructure projects or not, and what that will mean for how we transport people and cargo around the world. Some of the most interesting things I see are also in the shipping industry. The world's cargo and shipping is really an area where we have the opportunity to make some of the biggest cuts in carbon emissions. So hearing what different segments of transport and infrastructure are doing to make change is really exciting. Electric vehicle market trends really vary around the world, and some of the factors that determine that are quite, you know, literally the market setup, regulatory environment, encouragement of that, and then also infrastructure. Is charging infrastructure available, and can the grid support all of those individuals plugging in individual vehicles? But the other thing outside of especially North America is ride sharing. And so that's really going to impact how many electric vehicles do you really need? How are you sharing them? What technology and data can you use to understand the capacity you have available and the demand that you have as well? How do you match that up without necessarily requiring every human on the earth to have their own vehicle? So you see these trends in different places. Some of them are really pushed by air quality concerns and climate and pollution. Some of them, it's just plain congestion. There's not space for that many physical vehicles to move people and things around. So it really is interesting to see as we go around with the ABB Formula E Championship. In these different cities, there are different concerns and different topics, but in the end, it's really this earnest push that something has to change and that new technology is exciting.